On May 22, 1915, the Lassen Peak volcano in California produced a powerful explosion. As a mushroom-shaped eruption plume rose more than 30,000 feet into the atmosphere, pyroclastic flows raced across the nearby landscape, destroying 3 square miles of forest. What had just occurred was the largest single explosion of Lassen Peak, which erupted continuously from May of 1914 to June of 1917. Although the destruction caused by the eruption that day would go on to cause Lassen Volcanic National Park to be created to protect the area, the eruption was rather small. Going back further in the recent history of Lassen Peak, you can find 4 more powerful eruptions. One of these older eruptions was so powerful that it coated the nearby landscape in layers of ash taller than a 3-story building and caused several inches of ash to fall as far away as Yellowstone National Park. So, when and where exactly did this eruption occur? Just how powerful was it? This video will answer these 2 questions and discuss the geologically recent mega-eruption of the Lassen Peak volcanic complex. To understand just how powerful this mega-eruption was, visualize this. The town of Manton is 17 miles to the west of Lassen Peak, which is generally upwind away from where ash would fall during volcanic eruptions. Yet, during a span of less than 24 hours, it was covered in 197 feet or 60 meters of ash. Closer to the vent which produced this eruption, the ash piled up to more than 260 feet thick. However, at the site of the eruption, what used to be a set of jagged peaks was instead a massive, several-mile-wide crater in the ground called a caldera, which is more than 1,000 feet deep. If you were to have viewed Western North America from space after the eruption occurred, you would have seen the states of California, Oregon, Idaho, Nevada, and Utah all covered in a gray layer of ash. Everything just described was caused by an eruption which occurred 609,000 years ago at events southwest of the modern Lassen Peak at the modern site of Mount Tehama. When the eruption occurred, Mount Tehama had yet to form, and instead there was a complex of large lava domes in its place, which looked quite similar to the modern summit of Lassen Peak and its associated secondary peak called the Chaos Crags. These groups of lava domes were closely spaced along a line of activity, representing a massive underlying magma chamber. They were built by 200,000 years of activity, during which the underlying magma chamber leached material from the surrounding crust, slowly becoming more and more silica-rich. Eventually, its composition changed from dacite to rhyolite. This change was quite significant as it made the magma more viscous. The more viscous magma is, the less easily gases in it can escape to the surface, such as sulfur dioxide and carbon dioxide. Thus, with more gas present, the magma chamber became overpressurized, leading to an unusually powerful explosive eruption. When this volcano finally erupted, all of this gas was released in a short time span, sending a plume of ash more than 45 kilometers or 147,000 feet into the atmosphere. As millions of tons of volcanic rock were ejected per second, the columns soon collapsed downwards, producing a highly energetic pyroclastic flow. This flow likely incinerated everything in a 20-mile radius, reaching up to 40 miles distant in some locations. Then, due to the large volume of material which had erupted, the center of the volcano collapsed downwards, forming a large caldera. The reason why this caldera is no longer visible is it was quickly covered in lava from subsequent eruptions. One of these long eruptive sequences built a now-destroyed 11,000-foot-tall volcano on top of the caldera, so any resemblance of the original caldera rim is long gone. While we don't know how large the caldera was, it likely was at least 3 miles wide and may have been as much as 6 miles long. In total, the caldera-forming eruption which formed the so-called Rockland caldera ejected 50 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock, which was 50 times larger than the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens. This was the second largest volcanic eruption to occur in the entire Cascade Mountain range in the last 1 million years. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron known as Spock's Daughter for supporting this channel.